You see, from the very beginning, I have been emphasizing on the basis vectors. Okay? Without basis vectors, you cannot develop anything in quantum mechanics. So you always need basis vectors. Now, once we go to so-called, in the first place, I have told you in my previous lectures that the inner product my beta x u x beta x alpha go through under symmetry transformations like that of tan translation u dagger x u alpha, and from there one can develop two approaches. In one approach, this is the Schrodinger approach, okay? So the operator x remains operator x, and the integral vector alpha goes to u of x, okay? In another approach, operator alpha remains alpha, but u x goes to
normality is this and this is
delta A prime. Okay? And of course, this would also have, now I no longer have space. If you like, I'm just good. Let's write sigma A prime. A prime B, this is H, this is H, A prime B. Okay, so this I expect to be equal to the unit operator. You would expect it to be the unit operator because that's going to be your closure property for the Heisenberg base model. Okay, and this you can very easily verify that this would be summation over A prime Schroedinger of A prime and A prime of U. Please note off. My eyes and ears are very, very sensitive, okay? Please note off. So, this is this, and this is equal to summation over A prime, A prime, A prime, U greater than U. This is your identity operator, so you know that this is unit operator. So it satisfies all the requirements, it satisfies the orthonormality property, and therefore they could be moved as the base vectors, and they do satisfy the closure property, okay, which you need for any state vector. Fine. Now let me try to construct these. That is like a construct this. So what happens is I did A of H and Schroedinger A prime. I want to consider this, and so what is this like? This is equal to Schroedinger. I am going to put for A of H. Schroedinger A of S and U. This is my A of X. Okay. Is that fine? And then you are taking Schroedinger of A prime. Right? This is Schroedinger of A prime. Please, instead of talking to yourself, please talk to me. If you can't understand even with my explanations, you can never understand it by talking to yourself. Never. Okay, so this is fine. And then my Schroedinger would give me a unit operator, and therefore what would I get? I would get this equal to Schroedinger A of S into a unit operator and A prime. Alright? And now this is my Schrodinger operator. So you already know what it is. This would give me A prime. And therefore, what should I get here? A prime together A prime. And this I would write as I give it another name and I call it as A prime. And so I define A prime B this and you can have A prime. Is that clear? You see, what I am doing? That's another look here. Okay? I start from the first line. I consider two dagger times the state can A prime. This is state can of iron cat A prime in the base vector in the Schrodinger approach. This is a base cat in the Schrodinger approach. You see what we are going to do. Whatever we are going to construct in this approach, we have to borrow things, the relevant information from whatever is already available to us. So this is your This, you know, is your A. A prime is A prime. A prime, what is this? This is the power F. Okay, so is this fine? What is this operator? We have been talking about it for 7 weeks now. You are finding the operator, but it does not involve this time. Okay? Now, here what we have is, so I have this. Okay? And now, for A of F, which is Heisenberg operator, I write U dagger A of SU. Okay? And times U dagger A times, and now that it change. Okay, so now this is U dagger AS and U dagger is a unit of it. Alright? I'm giving it step by step. I've cut it into pieces very properly. Okay. And okay, then this is my AS, which AS is just the same as this operator A. So AS of A is in A prime, A prime, A prime is the number I write it here, and two letters in prime. And so A prime times A prime B. Now what I do here? This is your result. Okay? So for this, you get this. Therefore, this is the eigenstate of this operator with the eigenvalue A prime. So, I do the renomenclature. Okay? I want to do renomenclature and I want to say this is I name again as A prime F, A prime D F. So, this is how I have constructed Heisenberg. Okay? Very good. Now, let me find out what else I can do with this. So, let us find out the Schroedinger equation. Okay? Let us see Schroedinger equation. What happens to Schroedinger equation in the Heisenberg representation? So, I take I have cross, I will have cross that over MD for and you get, that is what I want to do. Right? I'm beginning from here. That's the point I'm beginning. So, I want to take this, and this should be equal to I will have x cross 10 over 10 t. Now, this guy is u dagger u dagger A prime. This is U dagger A prime. Okay? Alright? Now, U dagger, I know is what is my U dagger. U dagger is B to power iota SB by S cross, where E0 has been set to 0. Right? The initial time E0 has been set to 0. So, you write it down like this. And then to take the time derivative of this, so this is going to be equal to iota s cross. Now that over density of two vector gives me iota and iota s cross times e to the power I s cross. And what else? Oh, this is U dagger, so I should have A prime. I should have it. A prime here. Alright. This is okay. This is okay. Alright. So, now this is equal to iota into iota is minus h of the base minus h into. Now for this, I write back U dagger, or A prime, which I can write as minus x so what do I get is either x cross del over del t cos a by t then whatever this is equal to minus what is that? That is the Schroedinger equation for waves by the Heisenberg is the constant. Okay? Alright? And if you like, you could construct as usual in the particular case on the left hand side by x prime, okay, on both the sides, and then you can write it in terms of the like write it in the formula. So this is moving by and this is actually called the entire time dependence is carried by the state vectors and the operators and then it goes every time. The Heisenberg representation is the other way around. Entire time dependence is carried by the operator. And the state vectors remain frozen in time. However, this is interaction representation. Here, this is intermediate situation. So part of the time dependence is carried by the state vectors and part of the time dependence is carried by the operator. Okay? Let us see how it happens. So here, I write A, I, if you like, I can also write it as A, Dirac, or A, direction. So I define it as e to the power I at 0, dy at cross, A of S, e to the power minus I at 0, dy at cross. The initial time t 0, that is set equal to 0. The initial time that is set equal to 0. So this is the operator defined in the interaction representation, and alpha t0, let me say t0 equal to 0, and t, this is your state vector in the interaction representation. So how will this be defined? This is defined as e to the power iota cross t by the cross. Okay, times alpha and t and s. Okay. So this is how we define the operators and the state vectors in our intermediate representation. Okay. And what kind of equations of boson is satisfied? So I will make a draw del over del t of alpha d d t is equal to right. T times alpha T0 and T alpha. So this is Schroedinger equation. Then one more equation you need to have, d by dt of AI T. So this is minus iota by cross. AI of D and 0 plus L A of I D so what happens is the following. You define your Dirac operator or the interaction operator in this lesson. And you define your state vectors in the interaction or Dirac representation like this. And then you study so the time development of the state vector in the interaction representation is given purely by the x prime of t, which is time dependent. In quantum mechanics 2, you would start calling it as the observation part of the theory. I find sometimes your nuclear physics teacher is using this terminology, observation or something. Anyway, you will do it in detail in quantum mechanics 2. Anyhow, it is this time-dependent part of the Hamiltonian that evolves the state vector of the theory. Okay? And at the same time, you see, the operator also carries time dependence part A, and this is being given by the usual by the Heisenberg equation of boson. So this operator gives you the time time with the quiz and get the development of the so, you see, the time development of this operator in the interaction representation is determined by the free part of the Hamiltonian, which is independent of time. Okay? And the time development of the discrete vector in this representation, in this approach, is given purely by the conservative part and dependent part of the Hamiltonian. This is the time dependent part of the free part of the Hamiltonian. In the sense, it does not depend on time. Okay, so it is really non-interactive. All right. Is this fine? Okay. Now, one more thing you will have is that if you have the operator let me write here S B of S. This would be I, C of M, and you would have A of H, B of H equal to I, iota times C of H, and A of I, B of I. This would be equal to iota times of I. Okay. Alright? So, what is this? You know, without putting this superscript, you already know this, that in general, and the commutator of A and B would be expressed as iota times C, some another term operator, where A, B, and C, each one of them is a Hermitian operator. Okay. So, this iota is necessary because a commutator is anti-Hermitian, and therefore, if you put iota times C, then the right hand side is also anti-Hermitian. If you don't put iota, then the equation would be directly. Left hand side would be anti-Hermitian, right hand side would be. So we put iota times C. So, but now the point is, if some operators A, B, and C, which are the Hermitian, if they obey a certain commutation relation in one of the representations, they would continue to obey similar commutation relation in the other. So this is in the Schroedinger, this is in the Heisenberg, this is in the interaction or Dirac. Alright? Okay? And this, let us see how do we prove it. So, could I erase now from this part? The commutation relation of A of H, B of H, and this should be equal to A of H, B of H minus B of H, B of H. Alright? Okay? Alright? So, and this, you know, A of H, B of H, this is something that is two dagger. A of H, U, B of H, two dagger, B
S U one dagger V of S U times dagger V of L and U. Is this okay? For U and U dagger, either you can write in terms of U and U dagger, or you could write also in terms of E to the power iota and so on. Either the exponential or for like this, tell you this, and then this U dagger, unit operator, U dagger, unit operator, and then so. Then I could begin write it as U dagger, I could be out, and K of S, and V of L, and U, or in other words, you could put it as V. Cross